200 medley.
Hello and welcome to RTC TV4. I'm Abby Malco, and here with me today at the Warsaw Swimming and Diving Girls Sectionals is Mason Brady, closest to me, and Carmen Reeves. Hi, guys. Thanks for joining us.
Hi.
How is everyone today?
Wonderful.
Pretty good.
Looking forward to a good sectional final day.
Oh, yes.
Oh, I'm just going to forewarn everyone. I'm going to be the question asker. I do not know much. I learned a little bit at TRC when we spent time with Carmen, but these two beside me will be the wealth of information. So if you guys are ready for that, then I'm good, too.
All
good.
Right.
We're ready.
Good. So we had diving this morning, and they'll be hopping in the pool for event number one, which is?
200 medley relay.
Mm-hmm. Perfect. So Tippy Valley is in lane three, Pioneer is in lane four, and Manchester is in lane five. This is heat B, if I'm correct. Kind of, they called it the consolation in the scratch meeting that I was in earlier today. So the next heat is what they consider the finals. Is that correct?
Correct. And people, if somebody would swim faster in the consoles, they cannot move up because it was a time, it is a prelim final.
Okay.
So they can't move up at all. That is not true with diving when you get to diving.
Okay, so a little bit different rules there.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So if you are in heat, the consolation heat, and you get the state cut times, are you still able to move to state?
I think the state cut time would be still state cut, but they would place
you'd be placed
ninth. As opposed to top eight.
Okay. That makes sense. So once you're in the finals heat, the worst you can get is eight. Even if somebody swims faster than you in the consolation heat.
Correct.
Right.
Okay. So looks like Manchester is ahead in lane five.
Mm-hmm. Looks like Pioneer may be catching up a little bit here.
And if this is the second swimmer, if I'm correct, that's Cassidy Ward for Pioneer.
This is actually the third.
It is a third, so that's Megan Chan coming in. And you're right, she has caught up quite a bit.
Well, they qualified first, so I figured somewhere they were catching them.
Mm-hmm. And do the seeds coming into each race, that just depends on the results from the whole season?
No, prelims.
Okay, mm-hmm. Prelims from Thursday.
It looks like lane five is passing her by. But coming in today, it'll be 4, 5, 3, 6, 2, 7, 1, 8 as far as the seating has gone.
Okay. It's a good memory. A
as opposed to prelims, your fastest is in the last heat, your second fastest is in the second to last heat, your third fastest, and then they top 24 seated that way.
Okay.
They call it circle seating.
Circle seating.
Mm-hmm.
Good to know. Learn something every day. I have a feeling I'll learn a lot today. That was Manchester with the win for the relay.
To get ninth place.
Yep. Mm-hmm. In the consolation heat. Yep. I'll have to specify.
Next up. Final of the girls, 200 yards.
So in the final heat, Plymouth will be in lane one. Rochester will be in lane two. Warsaw will be in lane three. Columbia City is in lane four. Huntington North in lane five. Wabash in lane six. Lewis Cass in lane seven. Logan Ford in lane eight.
By us being in lane two, we qualified fifth.
Okay. So we just watched the parade go through, and they'll do that before every event, correct?
Yes, and I know you can't hear the song out there, but for the people up here in the station that have no clue how it's chosen, the winning person or team chooses what they're marching into.
Chooses the parade. So is that something that happens at every sectional or something that's special here to Warsaw?
Gracie Holm.
I'm not sure.
It did not used to happen at some of the sectionals that I went to prior.
Uh-huh.
So and it didn't even used to here at the very beginning. So they've just only done it maybe 10 years now or so.
Something they've added a special touch to let everybody know this is the finals, this is the big race, and a little bit of excitement before it all gets going.
Yes.
So for Rochester, Kennedy Campbell, Paige Bodie, Adrian Shepard, and Sarah Schaller will be in the relay for Rochester. You said we are in lane two, which
Columbia
means we are in fifth place for prelims.
Cecilia Hatcher, Megan Cummings, Shawnee Young, Lindsay Hoskins. Lane five, Huntington, Emma Helmet, Macy Lane, Allie Oshman, Lainey Shaw from Wabash. We have Mallory Hipskin, Alexis Hartley, Morgan Owens, Katie Ford. Lane seven, we have Cass with McKenna Wolf, Allie Carden, Lauren McLeland, Michaela Walker. In lane eight, we have Logan Sport with Erica Mullins, Abigail Newell, Maya Dominique, and Sophia Rosie.
Come on, Kennedy.
So what would be the strategy for this medley relay?
Swim fast.
Yeah. As a coach, does it matter? You just want your four fastest swimmers?
No. Now, it depends, because a lot of times your four fastest swimmers, depending on each stroke,
yep,
you may find that they are better in a different relay.
Right.
Stephanie and Kevin chose to put those girls in the 200 free relay and the 400 free relay. These girls are fast as well. I'm not saying that.
Right.
But I'm just saying that, for example, Abby McCarter is the number one breaststroker, so I'm guessing that Paige is the number two. Is that correct,
okay,
Mason?
Yes.
So it's a lot of strategy as far as knowing your players, knowing which race to disperse your players, and obviously when you have, your swimmers, and obviously when you have a relay, it's a little bit easier to mix up your swimmers since you have four in the event.
Correct. And if you looked at the program, you noticed that Emma Feldman and Abby McCarter and Maddie Sailors were in there as well.
Yes, as the alternates.
But they're only alternates because she chose to put them in the other events.
Okay.
And therefore, that's the way you have to go. Also, one of the things that a lot of people don't know, I'm sure Mason knows this, but the four swimmers that swam on Thursday do not have to be the four swimmers that swim today.
I did learn that in the scratch meeting. They had to go through and list one through, if they had seven swimmers, list the numbers specifically. So at first I was a little confused thinking that, oh, obviously your top four would swim, but.
And you know, no, they figure if they can swim and rest them for a different event. Notice lane three just won it.
Yep.
That's the third seed from the other night.
Wow.
And here comes these two, and five beat four, I believe, on that with the touch I just saw. Yeah. And so Rochester ended up sixth in that.
So Warsaw won the 200
medley relay. And that they will go to state.
Okay.
Now, any other team that goes has to meet the state cut, or have within the time with between whatever.
And the state cut time is 1:49.48.
Right.
So Warsaw would have been the closest, but they obviously got first, so they took
times
care of that.
Times are official.
And that is the only one that'll go then.
Okay.
Because my guess is the second place time at 2 minutes.
Nope.
Most likely will not be fast enough to even make the cut after. What they do is fill it with the winners plus whoever makes state cut, then the difference between there and 32, the next fastest teams will make it.
Okay. So when you're going to state, let's say that there was four teams that had a crazy race and all four teams made the state cut times. There is no limit at state to how many teams can make it?
Go ahead, Mason.
I think that all four state or all four teams would go to state.
Okay. They would.
Yeah.
So it's not like, oh, sorry, you were the last of the state cut times.
Yeah.
You just all get to make it once you make it.
You will make it. They will make an extra heat if there's too many of
them.
Sometimes you see that in the 50-free.
Yeah. Good to know.
And a lot of people who get first in this sectionals especially won't get the state time. A lot of them will just
make it first and then not be able to hit the state cut time.
This is not a faster one of the sectionals.
Right. Well, and I know we talked at TRC that Carmel has a very, very crazy sectional,
absolutely.
If I'm correct. So that is very beneficial for them to have state cut times for the teams that are probably never going to beat Carmel since they've won for how many years in a row now?
22, 27, it's
right.
An unbelievable amount.
So for sectionals
it's
like that,
for quite a while.
You almost have to have a state cut time in order to let other teams Manchester. Come in since Carmel has been clearing house, it sounds like, for
yes.
the past few decades,
yes.
which is so impressive.
Well, it used to be years ago, and I am talking years ago, top one relay, top three individual events. And it was that way. To try to equalize equal teams from elsewhere.
Yep.
But they found that that didn't work as well because of some of the teams being really overloaded.
Makes sense. Makes a lot of sense. Mason, your sectionals are 2 weeks from this weekend, if I'm correct?
Yes.
Boys swimming sectionals? Do you guys have any more swim meets before that time?
No. We'll taper for 2 weeks.
Okay.
So we won't have any more meets.
Because this past week you had a swim meet during the week, and so that was your last one until sectionals?
Yep.
Good to know. Good to get some rest and some extra practice before sectionals comes around.
Mm-hmm. Actually, they pretty much look forward to this because there's less yardage.
Yeah.
Trying to get them to that resting point.
Okay.
Those that they think will automatically make state will work through the sectionals finish their taper the week of state.
Okay.
It's real tough sometimes to know how to do that per individual.
And so explain the tapering process, because I am not completely aware, and especially for those who aren't aware.
The whole swim season is basically you're just pushing down a springboard more and more. And taper rests your muscles and helps you recover from all the weeks of, you know, going as hard as you can every practice. So it releases the springboard, and you'll see a lot of times drop by several seconds because just of the rest.
The different way that you've treated your body.
Yeah.
That makes sense. Very interesting. And then also, I was asking earlier, when we were at TRC, we saw all the girls wearing normal swimsuits, like the ones right in front of you. But then there's a couple girls that seem to have the longer suits, like the ones that are about to hop up here on the second. And somebody told me that these are compression suits, and they actually help you swim faster?
Correct, they do.
Okay, so give me some details about that.
And Lainey Shaw.
There's different kinds. There's tech suits and speed suits, and I think there's a couple different kinds. I don't know how Delaney accurate Weaver. It is, but they claim that they'll hold your muscles in different ways.
Really?
Kind of isolate the certain muscles that you need to use the most. And they're also like water resistant, so there's a lot less drag. Yeah.
Yeah.
That makes sense. Because we didn't see them at TRC. Someone said it helps you swim faster, so you don't want to wear that all season and then maybe do your best at sectionals. Is that kind of the ideology behind it?
Right.
Makes sense. Good to know. These are probably...
You will see a lot of that at state, and they also shave their bodies, not just shave with the boys. They shave their heads.
Really?
Yes.
With the swim cap on?
Yes, some of them do. Some of it's a psych job.
Really?
Yes. Gets them mentally ready.
Almost like if I were playing basketball and I decided I'm just going to have to wear this certain sock every single game, then
correct.
It makes me do better.
Correct.
So this is event number 2, girls 200-yard freestyle. For the consolation, in lane 1, Emma Gordon. Lane 2, Chase Cortez. Number 3, Maggie Vandersol, lane 4, Lainey Shaw, lane 5, Cassie Hardy, lane 6, Isabel Crod, lane 7, Macy Moon, and lane 8, Evelyn Goodman.
And they call her Evie.
Evie. Actually, Evie's younger sister does some pitching lessons with me, so I've heard some fun stories about those girls together.
From Logansport, lane 7, Macy Moon. From Pioneer,
so this is lane 8, Huntington, Evelyn North, Newman, Culver Academy, Rochester. Columbia City, Huntington North, Cass, Logansport, Pioneer, and Rochester.
All Evie can do is move up because she is in 16th position at this point.
That's good. Lots of times so when you don't have a lot of pressure and there's nothing to lose, you end up just doing your best.
Looks like lane 6 has pulled out right now.
That's Logansport.
And they have their coach is Heidi Hendricks, and Heidi Hendricks was an 8-time state place first. Eight times. Yes. Two individual events. Now she maybe have done some relays as well.
Right.
But she swam back when my son Flip did. She was a little older, a year or two. So I watched her come up through the ranks at Logan. She has a huge picture in the Logansport pool.
Oh, I can imagine.
Eight first place medals.
Yeah, that is very impressive. Probably helps to make her a very good coach.
As we talked before, sometimes you know it does, but I'm sure she understands taper real well and can get these girls where they need to be, because obviously the one in lane 6 did not swim this fast at prelims.
Yes.
Or she would make it in the final heat.
Right.
So she has something to prove, maybe even to herself.
Right, absolutely. And experience is something you can't buy nor teach, so having that as a coach, and obviously you see seniors having a little more success than you do as a freshman just in any sport.
Correct.
Having experience is always, always beneficial.
Nice.
So that was lane 6, Isabel Crod from Logansport.
And she, what was her time? I can't see it from here.
He will pop up the scoreboard and just, there it is. Her time was 2:15.34.
Okay.
And state cut is 1:52.99.
Well, it's not going to be state cut, but I was just interested to see if that 2:15 might have put
it's
her into
official.
The.
Scores are official.
Say 2:15.56. Would have made it in eighth place if the eighth place person here doesn't.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Finals of the 200 free.
Hi, I'm Chris Smith, PGA Tour player and Rochester native. Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester congratulates all of our local sports teams on another great season. Your hard work and dedication has made us all proud. We wish all of our local teams the best of luck in the postseason tournaments. Drive home a victory for your community. We are behind you here at Shepherd's.
Are you in pain from an injury or arthritis? What if there was a place that could meet all of your orthopedic needs? A place with some of the best orthopedic doctors and staff in the Midwest. A place where you're treated as a person instead of a patient. What if that place weren't in Chicago or Indianapolis? There is such a place. Rochester Orthopedics, your regional orthopedic specialist. When you're looking for comfort and relief, remember, trust the board-certified and fellowship-trained surgeons at Rochester Orthopedics.
And we're back after the commercial break. This is the girls 200-yard freestyle final heat. In lane 1, Olivia Livingood from Tippecanoe Valley. Lane 2, Emma Helmick from Huntington North. Lane 3, Lauren Cool from Warsaw.
Get out of there, Emma Feldman.
Lane 4, Hannah Young from Lewis Cass. Lane 5, there she is, Emma Feldman from Rochester.
Push!
Lane 6, Lauren Muller from Warsaw. Lane 7, Ella Spratt-Sarzinski from Culver Academy. And number 8, Elizabeth Tice from Culver Academy.
Come on, Emma.
And Emma's in lane
Five. She was seated second. So in order to go to state in this officially, she has to win it.
Win the whole race?
Right. Or she's still a little behind. Come on. There she goes. Come on.
It's a good turn.
Good turn. Yep.
Nice turn. Now she needs to keep pulling ahead.
There you go.
She's still in second at that turn after the 100.
And that's Young in first place?
Yes, from Lewis Cass.
Lewis Cass.
She seems to be catching her on the way down.
Yep.
Pulling out on the turn, but then Young catches up and goes.
Yep.
Now there's another 50, so maybe Emma State. Come on, Emma. Come on, right now. Put it.
There you go.
Come on, Emma.
And this will be the last turn?
Yes.
There you go.
Come on, Emma.
There you go, Emma.
Third.
So first place was lane four, Young from Lewis Cass.
And Moeller was second.
And third place was
Emma
Feldman. So Moeller came in right those last few strokes there.
Boy, she really
put it in. Times on the board are official.
Really great times. A lot of time drops in this heat.
Yeah. So when the announcer just said times are official, once the race was over, the girls kind of waited a minute and looked at the scoreboard. Do they have to clarify times before?
Yes.
Okay.
They have to make sure they're the difference between the backup time, which is that button,
uh-huh,
and are within a certain degree, tenth of a degree or less, then it's official.
That makes sense.
And there's two judges also writing down the order of finish.
Okay.
Or if someone would get disqualified.
Say that again.
Or if someone would be disqualified, they would announce that then.
Oh, okay.
Correct.
Have you guys ever seen that where somebody was in first or second place and then they come to the end and find out they're disqualified?
I have.
Oh, my goodness. That would be heartbreaking.
And my son could have been that way in the 200 IM as he started off with the wrong stroke.
Really?
Took two strokes and then all of a sudden realized and went into it. And that was in the prelims.
And that's a disqualification?
Oh, it should have been.
Oh, okay.
He did not. They missed it.
Right.
But it should have been.
Yeah, that would be heartbreaking to think you're racing the whole entire time and then find out at the
very end. Because he made state, too.
Yeah, absolutely. It's a game changer, for sure.
16th place, Chase Cortez. 15th place,
So first place overall for the 200-yard freestyle.
14th place, Macy Moon.
Young from
Cass. Hannah Young from Lewis Cass.
12th place, Emma Gordon.
What did you say the state cut time was for the 200?
The state cut time was 152.
Okay.
They won't
Cassie
make it.
Cassie Hardy.
Just
ninth
the winner.
Place, Isabel Crowell.
So Young goes automatically, and then no one else made the state cut time?
No one else made the state cut time.
And that differs from year to year, correct?
Yes.
They take it based on the eighth place or the 16th, I can't remember, for the last 3 years, take an average.
And that is
at state.
Okay.
Tice.
Makes sense.
From Huntington North, sixth place, Emma Helmich. From Culver Academy's fifth place, Ella Spratt-Sarzynski. From Warsaw, fourth place, Lauren Kuhl. Rochester, third place, Emma Feldman.
Nice job, Emma.
From Warsaw,
nice time.
Second place, Laurel Moeller. And first place from Cass, Hannah Young.
Feldman and Young for most of the race, and then, like we said, Moeller came in right at the end to grab second. Really? Mm-hmm.
But they all had good time drops from the other day, so
yes.
That was nice to see.
Next event is the girls' 200-yard IM consolation.
So this is the 200-yard IM. This is the consolation heat. In lane one is Paige
Rochester. Paige Bodie. Lane two,
Grace Holm from Plymouth.
Lane three,
Shauna Young from Columbia City. Lane four, Maria Hunting from Rochester. Lane five, Kristen Graham from Culver Academy. Lane six, Allie Carden from Lewis Cass. Lane seven, Megan Cummings from Columbia City. And lane eight, Elise Schuchter from Culver Academy.
From Cass, Allie Carden. Lane seven from Columbia City.
And what, in order of stroke, how does the IM come out for the first?
It's butterfly, backstroke, breaststroke, and then freestyle to finish it.
Okay.
And Maria's a really good breaststroker, and IMers who have a good breaststroke have an advantage.
Oh, really?
Yes. Mm-hmm. So hopefully it will show Maria passing lane three.
During the breaststroke.
And then if you remember, Paige Bodie swam the breaststroke in the medley relay.
In the relay, the very first event.
Come on.
And so this is
the breaststroke. Now it looks like the girl in three, Young, also has a decent breaststroke. But you notice that Maria did touch first on that.
Yep.
Great pull out.
Yeah, with a nice dolphin kick, too. Now, see, she really pulled ahead on that pull-out.
Yep. Right.
Mason's also a breaststroker and knows you can take one full pull, one full kick, and the head has to be up. But when they come out, they can take a dolphin kick.
Okay.
See right there? That was a dolphin kick to a flutter.
And so if any of those aren't to protocol, then that's disqualification?
Correct.
Right.
Okay.
And in this race, you can't use anything else other than the freestyle American crawl for the freestyle stroke.
Okay. We talked about that before at TRC, being able to throw in different freestyle swims.
Oh, Maria's looking really good. What was her time? 2:34.5.
And state cut time is 2:07.
Oh, it won't be close. That's consolation heat.
Okay.
She went a 2:27, so she dropped 7 seconds.
Wow.
From Thursday night.
Yeah.
Which is fantastic. That's just exactly what you want in a taper.
Yep.
They have to get in there.
Paige Bodie dropped a lot of time, too.
Paige dropped what?
A lot of time.
Yeah.
Went from 2:43.
Well, by winning that is not the never mind. That is the B heat, the console heat. That doesn't help her.
Final of the girls.
But if you look, had she swum that time,
individual medley.
That's close to the third place time.
Yep.
For the finals.
Hi, I'm Chris Smith, PGA Tour player and Rochester native. Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester congratulates all of our local sports teams on another great season. Your hard work and dedication has made us all proud. We wish all of our local teams the best of luck in the postseason tournaments. Drive home a victory for your community. We are behind you here at Shepherd's.
Here comes Emma. Is this Emma or Abby?
Lane yes. One from Culver Academy.
We'll Kylie, let the announcer get the lanes and names for
lane
you.
Lane two from Huntington, Allie Oshelman. From Cass, lane three, Marcel Carmel. Lane four from Warsaw, Delaney Weebring. Lane five from Rochester, Abigail McCarter. Lane six from Warsaw, Taylor Gunther. Lane 7 from Pioneer, Megan Chan. Lane 8 from Logansport, Erica Mullen.
So this is the finals of 200-yard IM.
Go, Ab.
And Abby McCarter in lane 5.
And again, she is a breaststroker, so watch on that breaststroke
yep.
lap of how she comes back. Hopefully that will be strong enough that she can get into first.
Yes.
But she's got to take it out. She's got a nice butterfly coming up here.
And so you have to jog my memory. The first seated swimmer
is in four.
Is in lane four. Okay.
Abby's seated second. Abby seemed to, well, I guess lane two, they said touch first there. Isn't that right? No, somebody touched. Well, maybe. Lane two's out there.
It was a great underwater from Abby. She made up a lot of ground.
Come on, Ab.
And Mason, you being a swimmer as well, is there a lot of technique when it comes to your turns? Like, can you live and die by your turns?
Oh, yeah. Turns mean everything.
Okay. Because to the spectator who doesn't know much, you would think, oh, you know, you have to get it in the lane. But knowing sports enough, I knew there had to be something with the turns as far as the technique to get out and in front of the person beside you.
Well, it looks like that girl from Warsaw is also a great breaststroker.
Yep. I think that's the...
Weebring?
Yep.
Come on, Abby. Well, on the breaststroke lap, you can compare the two, and then Weebrink was still a little faster.
Yep. Because these are the splits up on the board.
Correct.
Is that correct?
I was looking to see if that lane two would come back into the picture much.
So Weebrink from Warsaw was in first place. Abby McCarter in second place in lane five.
And lane two, Eshelman was third.
She is from Columbia City. Nope, that's Huntington North.
Abby had a very nice time drop. 2:22 in prelims
results
to 2:16.
Official.
Yes.
And that's another 6 seconds. That's great.
Mm-hmm.
And the Warsaw girl dropped 4 seconds. So Abby,
and is that normal to drop that many seconds from
totally
prelims to
if
now?
If they're totally tapered, the answer is yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, throughout the season, that's not normal.
No.
Correct?
Because they're swimming major yardage.
Right.
In fact, they'll go up and down depending on how much yardage they've had that week, depending on if it's a big meet, if they're swimming through it.
Right.
And a lot of people who are not involved in individual sports don't understand that.
Right.
At all. Like, why can't you get your best time every
right.
meet?
Mm-hmm. Well, that's like saying, why can't you hit a three-pointer every single time you shoot it? You know, like that's
right.
almost.
You
have
or you
yeah,
had 30
days.
Points yesterday. Why didn't you get 32 today?
Yeah, why'd you only have 2 points this game? Yeah.
15th place, Megan Cummings. 14th place, Paige Bodie. 13th place, Gracie Holm. 12th place, Kristen Graham. 11th place, Allie Carden. 10th place, Shawnee Young. 9th place, Maria Hunting. Eighth place of the 200 IM, Megan Chan from Pioneer. Seventh place, Kylie Diner from Culver Academy. Sixth place, Marisol Carmel from Cass. Fifth place, Taylor Gunter from Warsaw. Fourth place, Erica Mullins from Logansport. Third place, Allie Oshelman from Huntington North. Second place, Abigail McCarter from Rochester.
Way to go, Abby.
And first place, from Warsaw, Delaney Weebring.
Uh-oh.
Looks like we dropped a ribbon there.
Hopefully that didn't go in the pool.
Well, oh, they have to ask.
Our next event is the girls' 50-yard freestyle.
We have a lost ribbon before the second event.
And they have to ask to go in.
Oh, they do?
Yes.
Okay. That's good to know, because I probably would have hopped in after the ribbon.
Nope,
and then
you don't do that. It would disqualify you. I don't know if it would because of the fact it was a medal placement. But
it wasn't just jumping in
for
fun.
I shouldn't even say medal ribbon because there are no medals in sectionals.
Right, yeah. Okay. So this is event
lane
five.
One,
no, event four.
Yep. Lane two,
the 50-yard freestyle. So this is the quick one. The sprint of all sprints, right?
Four.
Correct.
Amelia Shafika Horton from Culver Academy. Lane 5, Sophia Rosie from Logansport. Lane 6, Kinsey Prater. Lane 7, Sarah Schaller. And lane 8, Kelly Fry.
Nice breathing pattern by the Culver Academy
yes.
girl.
And first place was lane 4, Shafik from Culver Academy. Second place, lane 5, Rosie from Logansport. And third place, lane 7, Schaller from Rochester.
Good job,
Sarah. Way to
Sarah
go,
Schaller.
Sarah. That's a nice drop. Nice.
Finals of the girls
so next are the finals,
freestyle.
50-yard freestyle. We'll be right back after this commercial.
RTC TV Channel 4 is Fulton County's only local television station. RTC Advertising can insert 30-second commercials, sponsored programs, or business spotlights into Channel 4 and any of our top 12 most watched cable networks. If you don't have a commercial, RTC Advertising can create one for you. RTC Advertising wants your ad to succeed. With RTC Advertising, our audience is your audience. Your success is our success. RTC Advertising. RTC TV Channel.
Give your heart to your community this Valentine's Day with a special dedication from the Fulton County Community Foundation and their media partners. Each year, your contributions help fund countless community needs, from parks and playgrounds to scholarships and grants. This Valentine's Day, give the gift that keeps on giving. Choose from a song dedication, singing Valentine's in person, or even a Palentine for your pet. Contact the Community Foundation or pick up your order form from one of these locations.
Lane 4, Brenna Morgan from Warsaw. Lane 5, Madeline Saylor.
So in the finals here, we have Katie Ford from Wabash in lane 1. Lindsay Hoskins from Columbia City. Lane 3, Olivia Herman from Warsaw. Lane 4, Morgan from Warsaw. Number 5, Maddie Saylors from Rochester. Number 6, Paige Bootner from Lewis Cass. Lane 7, Sydney Brackenbury from Culver Academy. And Sky Fierstos from Manchester rounds it out in lane 8. Fast race here, ladies and gentlemen, so don't blink once they start.
Come on, Maddie. Come on, Maddie.
There you go, Maddie.
Very good turn. Going to be very close, right down to the edge.
Very close.
And looks like she got second place. So first place in lane 4. That was Brianna Morgan from Warsaw. Second place, Maddie Sailors from Rochester.
Now, she did not get state cut, but at 24.42 is close enough. It might make it in. And that's how she made it last year, is that within
that. So state cut time was 24.18.
And
she was
24.42.
So that's close enough, you're saying?
Saying it could be close enough.
Okay.
That's something we look for. And I think that last year, I don't know what her time was last year, but that time last year she got pulled in to fill out the heat of 32.
Okay. So you have to obviously fill the heat. So before I was asking, is there a certain number where they get cut off? So if there's not enough and your time is close enough to state cut time, then you get grandfathered in, per se?
It's not.
15th place, Kelly Free.
It's not grandfathered in. You have to get, let's say there are six places left.
Yep.
Did not make state cut.
Uh-huh.
The next six fastest times from all over the state will fill those.
Leah Smith from Plymouth.
Did that happen last year?
Sarah Shaw from Rochester.
So they won't find that out until
probably tomorrow after Rosie from Logansport. 9th place, Amelia Shafika Horton from Culver Academy.
Okay.
Because you can figure out how many have made state cuts from everyone. But some of your ones
from Manchester.
Yeah.
7th place, Sydney Brackenberry from Culver Academy. 6th place from Columbia City, Lindsay Hoxton. 5th place, Katie Ford from Wabash. 4th place, Paige Mutner from Cass. 3rd place, Olivia Herman from Warsaw. 2nd place, Madeline Sailors from Rochester. And first place from Warsaw, Brenna Morgan.
And so dives 9, 10, and 11. They will each do 3 dives, whoever made the final 12. Looks like they had quite a few divers this morning, or I guess they're doing 16.
All right,
so I
we're
going to
switch over to the diving well. Swimmers, if we could clear the diving well, let's get the divers up there.
Actually, after prelims, they cut it to 20. Do 3 dives in the semifinals.
Mm-hmm.
That was done this morning, and then they will cut it to the top 16 here. And of those top 16, you can move up as far as you can move up.
Okay,
it's different than prelims, finals, or even consoles and finals here.
So, right here on our paper, we have 22 names listed.
Right, they are not all going to dive, only 16.
The first 16?
Nope. You don't know that.
Okay, just whoever comes out right now?
Right, because you don't know. If you don't have the results from this morning,
right,
you do not have who are the top 16.
Okay.
So I know I asked, and Stephanie thought we, being Rochester, may have 2 that made it through.
Okay. So each of the 16 girls gets 3 dives
Correct.
For the finals. Okay.
We haven't had this many divers over here at Sectionals for quite a few years, so that's nice to see.
It is very good to see.
And they each have to do, there's five categories in diving. Mm-hmm. They have to do two from each category, plus one category is three. And they have to be all different, not different positions, all different dives from that category.
Okay.
You've got your forward, your backward, your in reverse, your inward, and your twist.
Okay.
And there's a way you have to put them in a certain order. In the first eight, you have to cover all five categories.
Okay.
And you will find that there are seven judges here instead of the normal three in a dual meet.
Yep.
And I believe at TRC we had five. Here you will drop top two, bottom
divers.
Two.
You'll get
say that last
entries.
Part again.
Here you
we'll
will
get going for the finals.
You will
of the
see
diving.
That they drop top two scores, bottom two scores. They're still only adding three middle scores.
Okay, but it and gives a broad, more broad spectrum to get the scores from with seven judges.
Correct.
Okay.
And that
good
way, somebody who is. Well, they see it from two different sides of the pool, and you're seeing it from a different angle, so it makes a major difference. So we usually watch to see if the one side is pretty close within a half to a point.
Yep.
And then the other side as well. They may not even correlate because one side may see it differently than another side.
Right. And so looking at the diving well over here, there's two diving boards. Is one specific?
Nope. They can use either one. They can even alternate dives on each.
Really? Okay.
It's their choice.
Whatever they're most comfortable mm-hmm. with. I didn't know if one was specific to certain dives versus the other. I know there's the...
Those are both 1 meter boards. So
okay.
Therefore, they are not. And like I said, my guess is... depending on your diver and whether or not they like the bounce of one.
Mm-hmm.
I have had, when I coached the diving, I had divers who liked, for example, the forwards on the far board, their inwards back on these on the this board.
Okay.
And it's all because of the way there are holes at the end of those, and which you can't really pick up on.
Right.
But it depends on the pattern of how far down it goes. And how much rebound there comes off of it. And
yep.
It depends on the girls and or boys who are diving of what they need to feel
finals
to
the
get
diving.
Their dives.
Interesting.
I'm not sure how much Mason will know on the diving here.
Not since too much.
Since he's not a diver.
How long have you been swimming, Mason?
This is my fourth year swimming.
So you started as an eighth grader.
Yes.
Awesome. And you'll see a lot of these swimmers started very young, eight and under.
Right. I wondered if you either saw the ones that started from when they were walking to the ones who kind of picked it up when they got older.
Right. Since Rochester does not have a middle school program, some of them will start in the Royals at different ages thinking, oh, that might
right.
be something I like to do. Even as eighth grader, I'm going to guess that he decided basketball was not for him.
Right.
And therefore decided, well, I want to try something else.
Right.
And therefore I'll try swimming. And
yep.
found out he was pretty successful and has stayed with it. So that's awesome.
That's awesome. So this is the parade to diving. We will be right back when diving finals begin.
RTC Fiber Communications is now serving the community of Argus. Now you can enjoy the incredibly fast speed and reliability of fiber internet. Stream movies, surf the web, or watch your favorite local videos on RTC4.com. All from RTC Fiber Communications, now serving Argus. Give RTC a call today or check us out online at www.rtc1.com.
Hi, I'm Chris Smith, PGA Tour player and Rochester native. Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester congratulates all of our local sports teams on another great season. Your hard work and dedication has made us all proud. We wish all of our local teams the best of luck in the postseason tournaments. Drive home a victory for your community. We are behind you here at Shepherd's.
Are you in pain from an injury or arthritis? What if there was a place that could meet all of your orthopedic needs? A place with some of the best orthopedic doctors and staff in the Midwest. A place where you're treated as a person instead of a patient. What if that place weren't in Chicago or Indianapolis? There is such a place. Rochester Orthopedics, your regional orthopedic specialist. When you're looking for comfort and relief, remember, trust the board-certified and fellowship-trained surgeons at Rochester Orthopedics.
Grace will be doing dive 5-3-2-1-D, reverse, one somersault, half twist, 3-1.8.
So we are back here, and this is the girls' diving finals. Carmen, I'm going to let you walk us through most of this since you know all the terminology and you have the pen in front of you. So you can kind of lead the way, give us your tips and all the good info.
You don't see that dive very often. It's a reverse somersault half twist. She didn't quite make the entire half twist. On the half twist, she should be facing the back wall. And she was a little short of the twist. The judges, you don't see flashing scores. They put it in a program there. It flashes up on the board, and it'll give it up there, and then they'll go too high, too low off, and only take the three scores in the middle to multiply it by the degree of difficulty.
Pioneer, 5-2-2-1-D, back, one somersault, half twist, free position, 1.7.
So this is Bianca Chan?
Yes. Now we'll have to listen carefully because some of these will be out.
Yep.
Now, with that half twist, she had to face the far wall, which she did. She took it out quite a bit. You actually want it up and in. Definitely inside the divers, or the scorekeepers. She'll keep two fours and a four and a half on that. And then the 21.25 is multiplied.
401B, inward dive, pike, 1.5.
21.25 is multiplied by the degree of difficulty.
Okay.
And the bottom score, 203, is her running total.
So her final is 203 at the bottom?
Yes.
For now the previous diver.
Now you have this diver who's, and I didn't hear who it was, it Cleveland from Culver? Or did you?
I didn't hear that either.
Nice dive.
That was very,
very
nice.
Very nice dive. Well, it wasn't Megan Thomas, so it is Cleveland. Megan Thomas
yep.
is next, so. She had a very nice score. She had 2.8s on that.
Yeah.
That'll be dropped, but she'll have 3.7s, 21 multiplied.
Megan
it's not
Thomas
a high
for
DD.
Rochester.
Yes.
But that's a very nice dive.
101C, forward dive tuck, 1.2.
On their approach, they have to have at least 3 steps before the hurdle.
Okay.
You can have more. You'll find most of these divers do 4. It's a better balance.
4 steps.
My belief, it's a better balance. You'll see
having
that.
An even number for each leg.
And she ended up with 4.5, 5.5.
Gracie Pearson from Pioneer, 5-1, 1-1-B, forward dive, half twist, pike.
Now that's a different type of half twist. You see them mostly in straight, but pike, very difficult to do.
And this is Gracie Pearson?
Yes, it is. I did hear that. She wasn't quite half twist. They look at it as their hands hit the water.
Okay. That's when this twist stops in the judge's eyes?
That's when it has to be not failed at that
okay.
point.
Okay.
Yeah, see, a couple judges thought she was failed.
Mm-hmm.
And therefore, they gave them zeros.
But those two get...
They will be dropped.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
So she'll have 3 fours.
Next diver, 101B, forward dive, pike.
Okay, Sydney didn't make it in.
Mm-hmm. This is Leah Boggs from Wabash.
I don't know what they'll call that. It could call it totally altered position because she totally tucked.
Uh-huh. Instead of?
Instead of the pike, which means the legs are straight.
Okay.
And should come up straight. Should score no higher than a 4.5, and my guess is it won't score that high.
Okay.
One of them called or failed.
Okay.
But notice the low scores.
Yep.
Next is Caitlin Robinson.
Caitlin Robinson from Rochester. 402C. Inward. One somersault. Tuck. 1.6.
That's a nice dive for her. Very nice. She didn't throw it that well in warm-ups, so that's nice to see because she totally got around. She was a little short in warm-ups.
Now, and from a spectator's point of view, that makes me a little nervous when they are
going
diving. Yes, back towards the diving board. It always makes your heart jump just a little bit. Hopefully you haven't seen too many crazy instances where they have.
I've had a couple.
Oh, probably not a fun day.
No.
For that. I think the hardest part would be practicing for those schools that don't have those cables, like you said, where you said some of them are able to practice out of the pool with those cables.
Oh, correct. They have a pulley system.
Yes, that's what you called it.
In which they work the dives on deck and can do them, and somebody has to spot and be there all the time, but...
But versus the times where you learn a new dive and maybe have a belly flop, I'm sure it's a little less painful with the pulley system.
Taylor Gabby for Logan Sport. 302C, reverse, one somersault, tuck, 1.6.
We lost another diver there.
This is Taylor Gabby from Logan Sport?
Yes. Oh, just a little over. One bad. That is not the dive they have up there for.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm. That was a forward somersault, and she was supposed to do a reverse somersault, at least according to the board, zero. It's failed dive.
Oh, so that would have been her next dive?
I can't answer that, but I do know that she did the wrong dive.
Okay.
What they announced.
Tuck, 1.6.
That won't score very high either. She was supposed to go in on her head.
Okay.
But as long as her hands hit first, it is not a failed dive.
Okay.
And I did not see the referee signal failed. Now, the girl that has her hand up over here, the judge that has her hand up, something did not go in correctly, and she's trying to get the referee.
Okay.
And the tricky thing about those is you have to put your dive judge number in there. She held up evidently they've had some problems over here because she held up a card to say
to get her score.
To get her score.
Some technology now, problems.
Yeah. And judge three is over on the far side and her
four
score.
For judge seven.
Thank you.
3.5.
I was going to say you may have a computer person if that changed her judge number.
Right.
To come back over.
Tristan Pearson from Plymouth, 201A, back dive straight.
Tristan Pearson from Plymouth.
Mm-hmm. Looks like she has a sister diving as, oh no, my fault. The other girl, Pearson, was from Pioneer.
Tiffany Hodge.
Maybe they're cousins.
Tiffany Valley.
Maybe.
102C, forward, one somersault, tuck, 1.4.
That was Tiffany Hodge from Tippecanoe Valley?
Yes. Another thing with the diving that is different than swimming, in they do not go directly to state, they go to a regional.
So I did see that on the IHSA website.
So 101A, forward dive, straight, 1.4.
So how do you move on from here?
Top three will go to regionals.
Okay.
And there are... then they will take the top eight from each of the regionals, and they will go to state. So there will only be 32 divers.
Okay.
The diving coaches fought for that for years. I was in on that fight at that time.
Yeah.
1 year at state, we had 62 divers.
Really?
Because top three used to automatically make it to state.
From each sectional?
From each sectional.
Oh, wow.
Howard and Willendorf from Logansport.
They would do
304C.
Three dives.
Reverse. Two somersaults. Tuck.
Wow.
And then
2.3.
Cut to 32.
So that was a long diving.
It was a long three dives.
Yeah.
And so now they start just like the swimmers at 32.
Okay. Makes a little more sense.
Spectators, if we could have quiet for the divers, that'd be a great help.
Rambunctious crowd.
I don't think they realize how their voices carry over there and then interfere with the divers themselves.
Right, especially if you're always practicing in a quiet facility,
reverse,
you know, with no fans around.
2.3.
You don't see many girls throwing this dive.
What's this one called?
This is a reverse somersault.
Okay.
It's reverse two somersaults tuck. And
This is?
This is, I believe it is Mallory Neuendorf from
Logansport.
Well, she was a little short. Max 2 because she never came out of it.
Okay.
Out of her tuck. So they're giving her max 2. My guess is because she got around that far, they'll give her all 2 points.
Okay.
But she'll end up with 6 times the 2.3.
So doing a difficult dive, if you don't make it, you still...
You will. I mean, obviously, if it was a zero or a failed dive, it wouldn't make any difference whether...
Right.
Whether which way, but with this, she still gets 13 points because of the degree of
difficulty. Isabel Lanius from Culver, 104C, forward, two somersaults, tuck, 2.2.
This is a very common dive for girls to do.
Okay.
Boys, there are some that do this, but I prefer a boy to do a 2.5 as opposed to a double.
Okay.
nice.
Wow. That's very nice. And from our angle, it looks like she came a little crooked off the board. Is that just where we are?
No, I believe she came off this corner a little bit, and that they should take a little off of that.
Mm-hmm.
But some do, some don't. Now, my guess is, I don't know which side, probably this side, saw it differently.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And she had 2.5.
And the Deutschers from Cass.
Ends up with 5.5.
101B, forward dive, height 1.3.
Her legs were a little apart, a little tiny twist on that.
Mm-hmm.
But that's one of the dives they call a required dive from the category. Sorry. And the required dive, you have to have one required.
Judge number one, I need your score yet.
One required from each category.
Okay. So this
was... And at least one optional from each category. And the voluntaries, the 5 voluntaries from each category can add up to no more than 9.0 on degree of difficulty. So sometimes you will see them throw the very first dive. But sometimes if they do, for example, 1.5 and a double
starting
and a 2.5,
10.
They'll do...
Spectators... does get noisy very quickly, so if you need to talk, there's a hallway out there. Starting round 10, Grace Kelly, Culver, 101B, forward dive, pike, 1.3.
So this is Grace Kelly from Culver Academy, starting
correct.
Round 2.
Of missed the slight split
Bianca
of feet as she entered.
301C, mm-hmm. Reverse dive tuck, 1.6.
Ouch.
A little far out instead of up in the air.
Right, and... she made it. It wasn't a failed dive.
Right.
But it was close.
That was Bianca Chan from Pioneer.
Georgia is our next diver. 203B, back. 1.5 somersaults, pike, 2.3.
This is a beautiful dive when it's done very well.
And this one's called what?
Back. 1.5 in pike position.
Okay.
As opposed to tuck that most of them do.
Mm-hmm.
Quinn Bixler, our diver, used to do this. And her whole leg was up against her whole body.
Really?
Oh, absolutely. Face was right up there.
Wow.
And you see, that one wasn't quite
right.
Tight. I mean, it was done very well. She didn't break her knees.
Yeah, that was very, very graceful. But yes, Quinn was in high school the same time I was and went to state.
Correct, 2 years.
Mm-hmm.
Megan, your next dive, 5121D. Forward, 1 somersault, half twist, free, 1.7.
Was Megan Thomas from Rochester.
Mm-hmm. She's come a long way this year. She's a freshman, so it'll be interesting to see her improve.
Yeah. Not very many freshmen on the list here.
No.
Gracie, your next dive, 302C. Reverse, 1 somersault, tuck, 1.6. You'll be doing dive 201A, back dive straight, 1.7.
Leah Boggs from Wabash.
That little bounce on the board, that's called an undulation.
Okay.
And that is on the fifth one, they're supposed to be moving their hands.
Mm-hmm.
And so sometimes they will take off if they have numerous undulations.
Okay. So more than five is not good?
Correct.
And that's different than a complete jump off the board?
Yes.
Jim, need your score. Caitlin, you'll be doing dive 5111A. Forward dive, half twist, straight, 1.8.
This is Caitlin from Robinson from Rochester here. Did a little bit of a bend in there. That doesn't make it totally straight. That's what the referees, I think, and they're also discussing whether she made it around.
Failed
and
dive.
They said they did not. So it was a failed dive. And I'm going to guess that Jim is now talking to her. I didn't see her dive before, but she has problems with some reverses. She may not dive next round. She may be disqualified.
Emma, your next dive, 5121D, forward, one somersault, half twist, free.
She did a nice half twist there with the somersault. She just pulled the feet around a little too far,
mm-hmm.
and it caused that big splash at the end. And the scores will reflect that to some
Taylor,
extent.
Taylor, your next dive, 204C, back, two somersaults, tuck, 2.2.
Ooh, short, and her hands were out in front of her.
Instead of up above her head?
Well, you don't want them up above, instead of down, max
two.
Oh,
okay.
But the max two is because her legs were not out.
Right.
They were still tucked when she went in the water.
103C, forward, 1 1/2 somersaults, tuck. 1.6.
Now with the hands above the head on a foot first entry, it's 2.5 to 4.5. It used to be max 2 for that as
okay.
well.
Tristan, you'll be doing dive 402C, inward, one somersault, tuck, 1.6.
Tristan Pearson from Plymouth.
That was nice. Abby liked that better because she didn't come quite so close to the board.
Yes, I did.
Although that, if you know what you're doing and take it up and around, really about a foot to 18 inches
Tiffany,
from the board is
your next
best.
5-1, 2-1, D.
I don't know if that's enough room
forward,
for error for
one
me.
Somersault.
I know, I know.
I'll have to jump
position,
closer to the shallow end to make
yep.
myself feel comfortable.
This is Tiffany Hodge from Tip Valley.
That was very nice.
And she got fives on it. That's good.
The best scores we've seen so far were
Alyssa,
pretty early on. Somebody
five,
got a
one,
7 or an 8,
one,
I think.
One,
I
right.
A,
forward, dive, half twist, straight, 1.8.
But you have to remember those. There were only 2 8s in there, so they did get
right.
cut. But it was nice to see that. I think they kept 3 7s, if I remember correctly.
Yeah.
Oh, that was a nice front dive half twist straight.
That was Allie Dolan from Plymouth.
Mallory, your next dive.
I think that was Alyssa.
Forward.
From Plymouth.
One somersault.
Oh, okay.
Alyssa
yep.
Gritton.
You're right. I had the wrong one.
You're hoping this diving ends soon so we can see the rest of the swimming.
So
I know.
We can get it all going?
You're right.
Because each has one more dive. That's correct.
Correct.
I'm learning a lot, though. Mason's pretty quiet over here.
I don't know much about diving.
And he should add, nor does he want to.
Just a swimmer.
Isabel, your next dive, 302C, reverse, one somersault, tuck, 1.6.
She's way off balance at the end.
Mm-hmm.
That's what threw her out, is her chest went way out over the board. She's probably very lucky she made that.
And there's a few dives where they will jump before the end of the board, just certain ones that...
That is, you'll see it, it's newer in diving. I call it the Texas two-step. I'm not sure that's what the term is called anymore.
That's five.
But that you saw probably 4 years ago, 8 years ago at the Olympics.
Okay.
To start with some of the better dives.
When they added
you have to be able
Emma,
to keep your balance.
You'll be
for
doing
sure.
dive
right.
104C.
And you have to take
forward,
a step
two
after it, which is your
tuck,
press into,
2.2.
So you have to catch that board correctly.
Right. Because if you don't and you jump yourself off the board, that could be
correct.
Bad.
Correct. What's a double? Forward double somersault.
That was the final diver for round two?
Yes. starting round three. Ooh, somebody liked it.
We're entering the final round of diving. Round 11, Grace, 301B, reverse dive, pike, 1.7.
They score well when you hit that pike and drop long.
Mm-hmm.
This is where you go forward and come back towards the board, as opposed to the inward, you stand backwards and come
okay.
towards the board.
Bianca from Pioneer.
This is the time you can see all their final scores so you can end up placing them.
Okay.
Bianca, 5321D, reverse, one somersault, half twist, free position, 1.8.
Was that a half twist?
Half twist. And I think when her feet hit, she had made it back around, but. Somebody over on this side scored to go in.
More technological issues.
Looks like the referee, Jim Simons, didn't get his in either. He had to put there. Oh, he put a zero in. No. He's signaling what he put in.
Accidentally put in a zero?
Well, if he put a four and Judge Ford just signaled she put a four, that's going to change the ultimate score.
Right.
There seems to be problems with this all the time when we have had sectionals here before. That. So we'll have to see if that's truly the final or if they will if they change it.
Do most swim meets operate with the card system where
they
just flip the numbers over?
They do on a dual meet, but here I believe they use, if they have the computer set up, they will use that scoring. But if two more go to fours, then one of those fours will stay with the score.
Right.
So they would get 10.5 times 1.8, I believe. They maybe cleared them all out, but they haven't cleared the board, so but I see quite a few of them putting numbers in.
Trying to reconfigure who.
Well, they
add what?
They called somebody over to get the. I think they're going to change it.
Mike, judge one is a four. Mm-hmm. Judge four is a zero.
Is a zero. Oh. Then it's not going to change.
So it's the same. They just had it assigned to the incorrect judges.
Okay. Sorry about the delay. Georgia, 5-2-3-1-D, back.
Georgia,
one and one
Cleveland.
Half somersaults, half twist, free, 2.1.
She's from Culver Academy.
Mm-hmm. And I've seen this thrown a couple different ways, but it's a back one and a half with a half twist. I've seen it thrown where you do the half twist right off the board almost, and then do like a forward one and a half, or you do the one and a half. She did the one with a half. That is the most proper way.
Yeah, it looks.
It was nice.
Very graceful. Have a seven up there.
She's been diving pretty well, I think.
Mm-hmm.
From
Megan.
I think that may be the one that's also had the 2.8.
Reverse.
I wanted to say, tuck. It's hard
1.
To tell.
6.
All swimsuits look similar, but as far as.
Well, you're correct.
She was earlier in the diving when that happened.
Oh, nice, Megan. She didn't have that dive for a long time, so that's nice.
Mm-hmm.
She went around a little too far, but she really is riding the board, which is very much what you want to do as you continue to dive, is ride that board.
Yep.
She's very smooth.
Gracie, you'll be doing dive 403C, inward, one and one half somersault. Tuck, 2.2.
Gracie Pearson from Pioneer.
And this is one of the ones you don't like that comes back towards the board.
Oh,
just thought I'd tell you.
Close my eyes.
Plus, she's doing an inward one and a half, not just an inward one.
Okay.
So she will end up on her head. She pushed back on it quite a bit.
Mm-hmm.
And has a fast enough throw she could make it around, which is nice to see. The DD may have made it run past Megan.
One. Jim, need your score yet?
More problems?
More problems. Jim tends to. I shouldn't say that.
Judge one, re-enter your score, please. Said he did. Three.
Yep, that's enough to beat, have her go ahead of Megan.
Mm-hmm.
Leah.
Boggs from.
You'll be doing dive
Wabash.
102B.
Wabash.
Mm-hmm.
Forward, one somersault, pike.
Nice Now, will there be another warm-up period for the swimmers?
There will be.
Okay.
10 minutes.
Okay.
Judge 5-1-4, Mike. Three and a half's the other. Mike, you just want to switch over the paper?
Mm-hmm. Mike, go
Let's
faster.
Let's go ahead and do the yep. cards. Put the electronic down. Four, four and a half, three and a half, three and a half, four, four, four. Emma, your next dive.
That'll be a lot
202C,
easier.
202C, back. One somersault, tuck,
technology
1.5.
Can either be super helpful or not. This is Emma from Warsaw.
Now, it should go a little faster with them being able to do that so they don't have to mess up with the...
Right.
Four and a half. Four and a half. Four. Four. Four and a half. Four and a half. Four. Taylor, your final dive. 102B. Forward. One somersault. Pike. 1.5.
Taylor Gabby from Logan Sport.
Five and a half, five and a half, five, 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 five. Mm-hmm. Shelby, you'll be doing dive 5-1, 2-1-D, forward, one somersault, half twist, free position, 1.7.
Shelby Pastika from Warsaw.
Four and a half, five, five, four and a half, five, five. Tristan, 5-2, 2-2-D, back, one somersault, one twist, free position, 1.9. Four, four, three, four, three, four and a half, four and a half. Tiffany, 5-4-1-1-B, inward dive, half twist, pike position, 1.7.
You don't see many inwards with a half twist, I'll tell you.
Four and a half, five. So
you did it very
well. Four and a half, four, four.
Tiffany Hodge
five,
from Tippecanoe Valley.
Four and a half. Alyssa, 5-1, 2-1, D, forward, one somersault, half twist, free position, 1.7.
This is Alyssa Gritton from Plymouth.
Four and a half, three and a half, two, half, three, two, two.
They must not have thought she got her twist in much.
Mm-hmm. Mallory, sorry about that. 5-1-2-1-D, forward, one somersault, half twist, free position.
Mallory Neuendorf from Logan Sport.
Got her arms down, so that's good.
Mm-hmm.
Five and a half, five, five and a half, five and a half, five and a half, five and a half, five and a half. Isabel, 5-1-3-2-D, forward, one and one half somersault, one twist, free position, 2.2.
Isabel from Culver Academy.
Five and a half, six, five and a half, five and a half, five, five and a half, five and a half. Emma, your final dive, 5-3-2-1-D, reverse, one somersault, half twist, free.
Looks like the two Culver Academy girls are 1-2, at least right now.
Says Emma from Lewis Cass, she'll be the final diver.
No, this is Allie Dolan.
Darn it. But she is the final diver.
She is the final diver from Plymouth.
Allie Dolan from Plymouth.
Two and a half, three, two and a half, two, three, two, two and a half.
I missed what that final was. It moved.
That concludes the diving.
Okay, 2:35, good.
Were you keeping
the competition pool is open for a 10-minute warm-up. We'll get going in 15 minutes, resuming the meet at 3:15.
Looks like 1-2 were Warsaw divers, or excuse me, Culver Academy divers, and your third diver is Shelby Pasica from Warsaw, is third.
So Grace Kelly from Culver Academy and Georgia Cleveland from Culver Academy?
Yes, Georgia is first, and
Grace Kelly
Grace
second.
Kelly.
And you said Emma?
Oh, my! No, not Grace Kelly. It's the Isabel is second.
Alenius?
Clear way down.
Okay, Isabel Alenius was second,
mm-hmm.
And you said Emma Pina?
I have Taylor. Let me see. Shelby Pasica,
that's what you said.
Third.
So according to your results, those are top three?
Mm-hmm. Taylor Gabby is fourth. Mallory from Logan is fifth. 57. Sixth is Tristan Pearson. Seventh is Gracie Pearson. Eighth is Emma Pena. And I think Megan Thomas, if I have figured this up correctly, is ninth.
Awesome. Those are your diving results. We have about...
Unofficial
diving results. Carmen Reeves, thank you. We have about a 10-minute warm-up period, 15 minutes until swimming starts, so we're going to run some commercials, watch the swimmers warm up, and we'll be back with you soon.
RTC TV Channel 4 is Fulton County's only local television station. RTC advertising can insert 30-second commercials, sponsored programs, or business spotlights into Channel 4 and any of our top 12 most watched cable networks. If you don't have a commercial, RTC advertising can create one for you. RTC advertising wants your ad to succeed. With RTC advertising, our audience is your audience. Your success is our success. RTC advertising.
Give your heart to your community this Valentine's Day with a special dedication from the Fulton County Community Foundation and their media partners. Each year, your contributions help fund countless community needs, from parks and playgrounds to scholarships and grants. This Valentine's Day, give the gift that keeps on giving. Choose from a song dedication, singing Valentine's in person, or even a Palentine for your pet. Contact the Community Foundation or pick up your order form from one of these locations.
Hi, I'm Chris Smith, PGA Tour player and Rochester native. Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester congratulates all of our local sports teams on another great season. Your hard work and dedication has made us all proud. We wish all of our local teams the best of luck in the postseason tournaments. Drive home a victory for your community. We are behind you here at Shepherd's.
Are you tired of your internet speed slowing you down? Not a problem. Get connected at the speed of light over RTC's advanced fiber optic network. Work, surf, or play on the net faster than ever before. Choose from multiple residential or business packages with speeds so fast, it'll have you flying away. Already have RTC's Fiber Connect internet? Upgrade your package today. RTC. Local services, local support, and local investment.
Are you in pain from an injury or arthritis? Are you in pain from an injury or arthritis? What if there was a place that could meet all of your orthopedic needs? A place with some of the best orthopedic doctors and staff in the Midwest. A place where you're treated as a person instead of a patient. What if that place weren't in Chicago or Indianapolis? There is such a place. Rochester Orthopedics, your regional orthopedic specialist. When you're looking for comfort and relief, remember, trust the board-certified and fellowship-trained surgeons at Rochester Orthopedics.
RTC Fiber Communications is now serving the community of Argus. Now you can enjoy the incredibly fast speed and reliability of fiber internet. Stream movies, surf the web, or watch your favorite local videos on RTC4.com. All from RTC Fiber Communications, now serving Argus. Give RTC a call today or check us out online at www.rtc1.com.
Are you in pain from an injury or arthritis? What if there was a place that could meet all of your orthopedic needs? A place with some of the best orthopedic doctors and staff in the Midwest. A place where you're treated as a person instead of a patient. What if that place weren't in Chicago or Indianapolis? there is such a place. Rochester Orthopedics, your regional orthopedic specialist. When you're looking for comfort and relief, remember, trust the board-certified and fellowship-trained surgeons at Rochester Orthopedics.
From Culver Academy's Grace Kelly for 14th place. 13th place, Emma Deutscher from Cass. 12th place, Bianca Chan from Pioneer. 11th place, Alyssa Gritton, Plymouth. 10th place, Shelby Pasita, Warsaw. 9th place, Megan Thomas, Rochester. 8th place, Emma Pena, Warsaw. 7th place, Gracie Pearson from Pioneer. 6th place, Tiffany Hodge from Tippy Valley. 5th place, Mallory Neuendorf from Logansport. 4th place, Taylor.
Davey.
Taylor Davey from Logansport. Number third place, Tristan Pearson from Plymouth. Second place, Isabel Linus from Culver Academy. First place, Georgia Cleveland from Culver Academy. The top four places do move on. The top four places go on to regional.
Culver, Plymouth, and Logansport diving coaches to the office.
The 100-yard butterfly consolation.
This is the consolation heat of the girls' 100-yard butterfly.
Culver Academy. Lane 2, Lauren McLean from Cass. Lane 3, Madeline Ray from Warsaw. Lane 4, Maddie Carmel from Cass. Lane 5, Adrian Shepherd from Rochester. Lane 6, Morgan Owens from Wabash. Lane 7, Cora Barnett from Manchester. Lane 8, Lauren Liston from Columbia City.
Come on, Adrian.
Adrian was seated second by a second.
By 1 second.
Second in this heat.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And she's so, in lane 5.
Yep. There you go, Adrian.
Come on, bring it in strong. The other girl's coming up.
And first place was lane 4.
So second was Adrian.
That's Maddie Carmel from Lewis Cass. And Adrian Shepherd was second from Rochester. Third place, lane 2. Also from Lewis Cass, Lauren McClelland.
The board is official. Championship finals of the girls.
So they will start the 100-yard butterfly, and we will cut to commercial. We'll be back after this.
RTC TV Channel 4 is Fulton County's only local television station. RTC Advertising can insert 30-second commercials, sponsored programs, or business spotlights into Channel 4 and any of our top 12 most watched cable networks. If you don't have a commercial, RTC Advertising can create one for you. RTC Advertising wants your ad to succeed. With RTC Advertising, our audience is your audience. Your success is our success. RTC Advertising.
Give your heart to your community this Valentine's Day with a special dedication from the Fulton County Community Foundation and their media partners. Each year, your contributions help fund countless community needs, from parks and playgrounds to scholarships and grants. This Valentine's Day, give the gift that keeps on giving. Choose from a song dedication, singing Valentine's in person, or even a Palentine for your pet. Contact the Community Foundation or pick up your order form from one of these locations.
Marisol Carmel from Cass, Lane 5, Emma Hemlick from Huntington, Lane 6, Taylor Gunter from Warsaw, Lane 7, Ella Spratt-Sarzynski from Culver Academy, Lane 8, Janelle Lee from Culver Academy.
This is the final heat of the 100-yard butterfly.
We have to switch.
Earlier in the 200 freestyle, Emma Feldman broke the Rochester school record that was set in 1982.
Yeah, it's one of the older ones. Mm-hmm. That's good.
What was the record and what was her time?
The previous record was 203.81. Emma's time was 203.18.
Very impressive. Congrats,
and
Emma.
Abby McCarter also broke her own record.
In the
200.
Great job, ladies. Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
always
very good
glad
job.
To see. Do you know who held that record in the 80s? Was it? I don't know if somebody had texted.
Lana Davis.
Lana Davis. I wondered. Somebody had asked how long that record was going to stay. Mm-hmm. So.
And first place for the 100-yard butterfly was Helmick in lane 5. And second place was lane 3, Ashleman, both from Huntington North. Third place in lane 4 was from Lewis Cass. That was Marisol Carmel. So the next event, event number 7, is 100-yard freestyle.
Maria Hunting is in this from Rochester coming up.
The board is official.
By the board being official, they now know which lane they have to go to stand on the block to get their ribbon.
Okay.
Results of the girls' 100-yard butterfly. 16th place, Cora Barnett, Manchester.
So it's interesting, the state cut time for
place,
that is
Chase
under a
Cortes
minute.
From
yes.
Culver Academy.
Very fast.
14th place, Lauren Liston from Columbia City. 13th place, Morgan Owens from Wabash. 12th place, Madeline Ray from Warsaw. 11th place, Lauren McLeland from Cass. 10th 10th place, Adrian Shepherd from Rochester.
Nice job, Adrian.
9th place, Maddie Carmel from Cass. 8th place, Janelle Lee from Culver Academy. 7th place, Olivia Livingood from Tippy Valley. 6th place, Shauna Young from Columbia City. 5th place, Ella Spratt-Sarzynski from Culver Academy. 4th place, Taylor Gunther from Warsaw. 3rd place, Marisol Carmel from Cass. 2nd place, Allie Oshelman from Huntington North. 1st place, from Huntington North, Emma Helmich. Event 7, girls 100-yard freestyle consolation.
We should be on the last track. Hey, Earhart.
Lane 1, Macy Moon from Pioneer. Lane 2, Sophia Rosie.
Looks like Maria's taking it out quite strong right
now. Lane 3, Sydney Brackenberry from Culver Academy. Lane 4,
she knows lane 5 was right,
Maria
right with her.
From yep. Rochester.
In the prelims.
Lane 5, Paige Buettner from Cass. Lane 6, Amelia
Maria turned second.
Horton from Culver Academy. Lane 7, Michaela Walker from Cass. Lane
their stroke
8,
rhythm
Warren
is pretty close
McLeland
to the same.
Yep. Cass.
And here they come.
It's like Buettner from lane 5.
One. That heat.
She was in first place. Maria Hunting from Rochester, second place. And lane 6, Shafiq from Culver Academy was third place in the consolation heat of the 100-yard freestyle.
The board is official.
Maria
I know
about
she, go
a
ahead.
Minute flat. It's pretty good.
Final, I was going to say, she took 2 seconds off.
Of the girls
and I'm
100-yard freestyle.
I'm sure she would love to have broken that minute.
Yes.
3, Kylie Dinner from Culver Academy. Lane 4, Madeline Sailors from Rochester.
Let's go, Maddie.
Lane 5, Brenna Morgan from Warsaw. Lane 6, Olivia Herman from Warsaw. Lane 7,
Emma
Goldman from Rochester.
Let's go,
Lane 8, Lainey Shaw from Huntington.
So the final heat for the 100-yard freestyle, 2 Rochester girls, Maddie Saylor seated number 1 in lane 4 and Emma Feldman in lane 7.
Maddie had a really good start.
Yep.
She's going out strong.
Long legs and long arms, very helpful here.
Emma's right up in there as well, which is looking good.
There you go, Maddie.
Come on, Maddie.
And the state cut time for this race is 52.4 seconds. Maddie swam a 55.7 in the prelims on Thursday.
Yeah, looks like lane 5 came off the turn a little faster. That's the girl that beat her, I believe, in the 50.
Yep.
Yep, same one.
And
so first place in lane 5 was Brianna Morgan from Warsaw. Second place in lane 4, Maddie Saylors from Rochester. And third place, Emma Feldman, lane 7.
Way to go, Emma. Nice improvement for Emma.
The board is official.
Emma went a 56. That'll help in that last relay for sure.
Absolutely.
And
counters for the 500. Please go to your place.
Maddie took
counters
a couple
for the 500.
Seconds.
Please get in place.
Maddie took 2 seconds off her time as well,
yep.
So that's good.
Yeah, they all had really good time drops. Good job, Maddie. Good job, Emma.
That'll be close whether Maddie can make that in or not.
Right.
From the rest of the 32. She's not quite at that state cut of 52-42.
And is the down and back after the race
results
a cool off lap for
yard
the swimmers?
Freestyle.
Yes.
16th place, Lauren McLeland from Cass. 15th place, Michaela Walker from Cass. 14th place, Sophia Rossi from Logansport. 13th place, Macy Moon from Pioneer. 12th place, Sydney Brackenberry from Culver Academies. 11th place, Aminia Shafiq Horton from Culver Academies. 10th place, Maria Hunting from Rochester. 9th place, Paige Buettner from Cass. Eighth place, Lainey Shaw from Huntington North. 7th place, Macy Lane from Huntington North. 6th place, Sophia Hatcher from Columbia City. 5th place, Kylie Dinner from Culver Academy. 4th place, Olivia Herman from Warsaw. 3rd place, Emma Feldman from Rochester.
Way to go, Emma.
2nd place, Madeline Sailors from Rochester.
Nice job, Maddie.
And first
good job,
place,
girls.
From Warsaw, Brenna Morgan.
So the long race is next, 500-yard freestyle.
500-yard freestyle.
This is the consolation heat for the 500-yard freestyle.
Rochester has two girls
lane
in here.
Lane 1,
Paige
Melissa
Bodie and Evelyn
Binney
Goodman
from Warsaw. Lane 2, Olivia Iding from Huntington. Lane 3, Maggie Vandersaw from Columbia City. Lane 4,
you know the race is long when you have somebody counting at the end for you.
Lane 5, Elizabeth Ellert from Culver Academy. Paige, number Lane 6, Paige Bodie from Rochester. Lane 7, Elizabeth Tice from Culver Academies. Lane 8, Evelyn Goodman from Rochester.
Mason, what events do you normally swim?
I usually swim the 100 breaststroke. That's my event.
Not a 500 guy?
Oh, no.
I don't think I would probably pick that one either. If
yep.
I wasn't scared of the diving board, I might choose that for myself.
That'd be tough if you're afraid of the diving board.
It would be. Can you teach me the dives where I jump way far away?
They don't score very well
no,
that way.
No, doesn't sound like it.
in college, they not only do a 500, they do a 1,000-yard one.
Really?
Yes.
So in college, what's a good time for that? How long does that take?
Well, it depends whether you're a boy or girl, or man or woman, I guess. You're going to see at state meet here that they will go for the girls. You may get somebody break 5 minutes.
Really? So just double
they're
that?
They're pretty good. Well, a little more than double.
Yeah.
So you're talking 10, approximately double.
Yep.
Is 10, a little over 10. And the men swim it a little bit faster than
right.
I know they also have the mile race in college and club swimming.
1650.
Yep.
Wow.
Or 1500 meters, whichever you want to go. Abby, is RTC selling the DVDs of these for anybody that wants to buy them from anywhere?
You know, that is a good question because it's IHSAA. Since it's sectionals, we have to pay to broadcast this. So we can broadcast this and it will be on our website. But I don't think we personally can sell sectional footage because the IHSAA owns it. So once you get into sectionals for every sport, there's specific rules and like they allow us to broadcast this. But it should be able to be on our website. So we can't physically hand you a DVD, but if you go to our website, we can have it on there.
And Plymouth for 53 points. Seventh place, Columbia City with 91. Sixth place, Logansport with 93. Tying for fourth place with
are they updating scores right now?
They are.
With 132. Third place, Rochester with 152. Culver Academy's in second place with 158. Warsaw in first place with 215.
Rochester and Culver scores are pretty close.
Yes.
Could turn into a good meet.
That the two relays could make a major difference because they are double the points. Mm-hmm. So the scoring there, 40 points for first place. And right now we are seated first in both, but then it does drop to, let me get my figure that I did that, 34. So there's 6 points difference between first and second on relays.
Okay.
And in individuals, it goes 20, 17, 16, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11. Then the consoles are 9, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And relays would be 40, 34, 32, 30, 28, 26, 24, 22. Consoles 18, 14, 12, because that's all the teams they have here.
Okay. Believe.
I know Warsaw is seated pretty close to where we are in the relays. They're seated second in the 200 free relay, and Culver Academy would be seated fourth, so we could pick up points a lot there if that stays.
Right.
And then in the last relay, we again are seated first by, again, I meant Rochester, and it looks like Warsaw must have either loaded their first one or saved their better swimmers for the last, that they didn't swim those girls on Thursday for qualifications.
Okay.
And Culver Academy in that one is seated 1, 2, 3, 4. And Warsaw is 5th.
So for the consolation of the girls 500-yard freestyle, in first place was lane 5 from Culver Academy, Elizabeth Ellert. Second place in lane 4 Isabel Crod from Logansport, and third place in lane six was Paige Bodie from Rochester.
Nice job, Paige.
Paige and Evie both have been dropping a lot of time all season. It's fun to see them drop more.
Yes, and perfect time.
The board,
no better time than sectionals.
Official.
And she is only a freshman, which is nice to see as well.
Right.
RTC TV Channel 4 is Fulton County's only local television station. RTC advertising can insert 30-second commercials, sponsored programs, or business spotlights into Channel 4 and any of our top 12 most watched cable networks. If you don't have a commercial, RTC advertising can create one for you. RTC advertising wants your ad to succeed. With RTC advertising, our audience is your audience. Your success is our success. RTC advertising.
Give your heart to your community this Valentine's Day with a special dedication from the Fulton County Community Foundation and their media partners. Each year, your contributions help fund countless community needs, from parks and playgrounds to scholarships and grants. This Valentine's Day, give the gift that keeps on giving. Choose from a song dedication, singing Valentine's in person, or even a Palentine for your pet. Contact the Community Foundation or pick up your order form from one of these locations.
Five, Hannah Young from Cass. Lane six, Adrian Shepherd from Rochester. Lane seven, Lauren Liston from Columbia City. Lane eight, Audrey Kirsten from Warsaw.
Adrian Shepherd from Rochester is in lane six for this race.
And Prater from lane one is Tip Valley.
Yes.
Do you have who's swimming for us in the 200 free relay?
I do.
Because I'm wondering if Adrian Shepherd is in there, because if she is, she may be told just to
She swim. Is not.
Okay.
For the next event, it will be McCarter, Feldman, Hunting, and Sailors.
Okay.
That would be tough to go from the 500 back to the relay.
It is tough. Oh, it can be done. But sometimes when they do that, they will say, you know, just swim through this and use it as a warm-up.
The 500?
Yes.
Yeah.
Because although she is in the finals, so we need as many points as we can get
right.
against Culver Academy at this point in time.
And this may be a crazy question to you swim folks, but is every race except the relays the same amount of points?
Correct.
Okay.
Including diving.
Okay.
They don't take the diving score as the score. They take the placing.
And so is track, are those events scored differently, worth a different amount of points when you go to track?
Correct.
Okay. I couldn't remember which one was which, but that makes swimming easier that they're all the same points except relays are double.
Yes.
I would probably give the 500 swimmers maybe a couple more points if I were the swimming boss.
Well, I'm not sure that that would be quite fair.
That's like, true.
Yes. And they do train differently than
right.
your sprinters.
Right.
Correct, Mason?
Right.
They have a lot yeah. more distance swimming.
Yeah, yep. we split the pool up a lot.
I was going to ask that, how a normal day of practice were to go.
A lot of times we'll have a couple distance people in one lane, stroke people in another lane, sprinters in another lane. And most of the time we all do the same thing, maybe just a little bit different.
Yep.
Like
a little different times on sets.
Yeah. Like a distance swimmer will do a 150 instead of a 100. A stroke swimmer, say you were good at backstroke, you would do backstroke instead of freestyle.
Okay. And so only so many lanes with many swimmers. Do you share lanes during practice and things like that?
Oh, yeah.
Bumping into each other every now and then?
Yeah.
Hopefully, they do circle swimming.
Okay. Yeah.
So that they're some coming off the block or off the far end of the pool swimming down while others are swimming back
yep.
towards the deep end.
That makes sense. That would not be good to dive on top of your swimming teammate.
That has happened.
Do you ever have competitions in practice as far as, you know, there's certain days, if I were to relate it to a basketball practice, which is what I know, we would work on our defense one practice, the offense the next day, and then the third day we would scrimmage and put it all together. So how does that work for you guys?
We don't really race a lot. Sometimes to help each other pace.
Yep.
We'll have two people swim side by side that are doing the same thing.
Yep. But a lot of it being in an individual sport in the aspect of a lot of it's pushing yourself. You know, if you're not able to push yourself in practice, then you're not going to be able to better yourself. So
right.
lots of responsibility and self-awareness there as far as the athlete that goes. You have teammates to help, but ultimately it comes down to you and how good you want to be.
Right.
Well, and their work ethic is
yes.
very important, and how hard they really push themselves
right.
every day.
Yep, because
including turns, including starts, including proper pullouts, etc.
And I'm sure it's hard as a coach to watch all the swimmers in the pool at the same time. So knowing not that you can't cut corners because it's not going to better yourself, that's a huge thing, and probably is what makes the best athletes the best because they do work so hard.
Right.
They do have three coaches pretty much in there with the swimmers all the time, am I correct?
Right, yeah.
And then the strength programming and the flexibility has become extremely important as well.
Yep, because you guys have what you call them dry land days where you do some running when you're not in the pool and kind of do some conditioning out of the water.
Yeah, we'll usually be in the weight room. We do a lot of like body weight lifting, like pull-ups
yep.
and push-ups and stuff. Looks like Adrienne is going to get third.
And is that lane four was the winner?
Yes.
Lauren Kuhl from Warsaw was in first place. Lane five, Hannah Young from Lewis Cass was in second place. And Adrienne Shepherd, like you said, from Rochester was in third place.
Adrienne had
a
great time.
Yeah, cut down 11 seconds.
Yeah.
It was a very good time.
The board is official.
So that completes the longest event so far with the 500-yard freestyle. The winner of that was Lauren Kuhl from Warsaw. Coming up next is the 200-yard freestyle relay. And for the consolation heat, Logan Sport, Huntington North Pioneer, and Manchester will be swimming that event.
And this also helps because Adrienne beat a Culver swimmer.
Oh, she did?
Yes.
Great.
In lane three. I mean, that needs to be something we need to keep track of all the way through to
right, see to determine the final scores.
Exactly.
Right.
But this next relay will really help us know what's happening.
And we will be back after this commercial break.
Hi, I'm Chris Smith, PGA Tour player and Rochester native.
Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester congratulates all of our local sports teams on another great season. Your hard work and dedication has made us all proud. We wish all of our local teams the best of luck in the postseason tournaments. Drive home a victory for your community. We are behind you here at Shepherd's.
Melissa Deming, Warsaw. 14th place, Maggie Vandersall, Columbia City. 13th place, Elizabeth Tice, Culver Academy. 12th place, Olivia Iding from Huntington North. 11th place, Paige Bodie from Rochester. 10th place, Isabel Crowd from Logansport. 9th place, Elizabeth Ellert from Culver Academy. 8th place, from Columbia City, Lauren Liston. 7th place, Kinsey Prater, Tippy Valley. 6th place, Lindsay Hoskins, Columbia City. 5th place, Audrey Kirsten, Warsaw. 4th place, Avery Golden, Culver Academy. 3rd place, Adrian Shepherd, Rochester. 2nd place, Hannah Young from Tass. And in 1st place, from Warsaw, Lauren Cool.
So now it's going to come down to the wire as far as
200-yard freestyle relay.
Those relays.
Yep. So this is the 200-yard freestyle relay. This is the consolation. There will only be four teams in this race.
That's because one that was in it scratched, you said.
Yes, Oregon Davis. That was the only race they had qualified in and decided not to attend. There's also a couple problems this morning. I think Culver Academy had some bus problems when coming here. So when we were at the scratch meeting this morning, they were kind of a little frazzled as they were trying to get their cards turned in, but everybody understood.
Miranda
things happen,
Mill,
so they were able to get here safely.
I don't know for a fact, but I'm pretty sure Culver Academy's bus broke down for boys sectionals last year.
Did it really?
Yeah.
Maya, oh my goodness. Either bad timing or
right.
They picked the wrong bus both times.
Bricknell, Gracie Dinsborn.
Well, at least
Mariana,
they made it.
Yes,
Dominic,
absolutely. That would be very unfortunate
Dominguez
to miss sectionals because of a bus problem.
Lane 4, Emma Gordon.
So
Alyssa,
this is Huntington
Brinkman
North in the lead here.
Alana Stroop, Olivia Iding.
On the team for Huntington North is Emma Gordman,
Cassidy
Alyssa
Ward,
Brinkman, Elena Stroop,
Stewart,
and Olivia Iting.
Tobol, Macy Moon, in lane 6, Haley Wampler, Lydia Greer, Morgan Jimenez, Lillian Meyer.
Is this the third swimmer for the relay?
I think this is the last one.
Final swimmer? You are correct. First place in lane 4, Huntington North. Second place in lane 5, Logansport. And third place, Pioneer.
The board is official.
Up next is the 200-yard freestyle relay final.
Of the girls 200.
We'll be back right after this.
Girls 200 yards.
RTC Fiber Communications is now serving the community of Argus. Now you can enjoy the incredibly fast speed and reliability of fiber internet. Stream movies, surf the web, or watch your favorite local videos on RTC4.com. All from RTC Fiber Communications, now serving Argus. Give RTC a call today or check us out online at www.rtc1.com.
Are you in pain from an injury or arthritis? What if there was a place that could meet all of your orthopedic needs? A place with some of the best orthopedic doctors and staff in the Midwest. A place where you're treated as a person instead of a patient. What if that place weren't in Chicago or Indianapolis? There is such a place. Rochester Orthopedics, your regional orthopedic specialist. When you're looking for comfort and relief, remember, trust the board-certified and fellowship-trained surgeons at Rochester Orthopedics.
Maida Fear, Blake McBriar, Olivia Livingood, Kinsey Prater, Lane 2, Columbia City, Sophia Hatcher, Maggie Vandersall, Shauna Young, Lindsay Hoskins, Lane 3, Cass, Paige Buettner, Maddie Carmel, Marisol Carmel, Hannah Young, Lane 4, Rochester, Abigail McCarter, Emma Feldman, Maria Hunting, Madeline Sailors, Lane 5, Warsaw, Olivia Herman, Laurel Moeller, Taylor Gunter, Brenna Morgan, Lane 6, Culver Academies, Aminia Shafiq Horton, Janelle Lee, Sydney Brackenberry, Kylie Dinner, 7, Lane 7 from Wabash, Morgan Owens, Alexis Hartley, Mallory Hipskin, Katie Ford, Lane 8, Plymouth, Leah Smith, Mackenzie Sheets, Michaela Ebert, Jessica Drury.
It's the lineup for the 200-yard freestyle relay. This is the final heat. And in lane 4 is Rochester. Up first, Abby McCarter.
I think they've got to get a lead for Maddie, because Maddie's coming off last, and then Warsaw's put in Brenna as their fourth swimmer.
Yep.
I don't believe that's who they had last time. And so by the time that third swimmer goes, I think we need to see a lead.
Have a pretty good lead. And what's the technicality? The swimmers can't go until the other swimmer touches the wall?
They can be in motion, but cannot leave the block. It's a very technical call until the other swimmer coming in has touched the wall.
Okay. So the feet, again, the toes have to be touching.
Well, it looks like right now we've pulled ahead. That's good.
Yep.
Oh, nice start. Great start.
And that was Emma.
Maria.
Maria
just jumped
for
in.
Rochester,
just
And they've got a good enough lead that I think between what we just saw at the 50 between Maddie and Brenna, that she can take it.
Might be able to get it.
I think so. Let's hope so.
Let's go, Maria.
Maddie has a
Come
good
on,
end.
Maria.
Finish now.
Nice start.
There we go.
Yeah. Come on, Maddie.
Oh, yes.
Come on, Maddie. Come on, Maddie. Come on, Maddie.
There you go, Maddie.
It's gonna be close.
Yes. There you go, Maddie.
Nice.
Way to go.
Nice job, girls.
That automatically qualifies that team for state.
Wow.
Automatically.
That is awesome.
Maddie is all excited.
The
looks like she's about ready to
official.
Yes.
Right. She knows she's qualified.
Yep.
Absolutely.
Yep, that's awesome.
And that is great to have a team of four there.
Right.
That is great.
And three of them being juniors,
yep,
with Emma the only senior.
Absolutely.
That is fantastic. Great swim by all of the girls.
They've been allowed to go back in and warm up in that lane so they can.
So Rochester in first place for lane four.
Where's Culver?
Warsaw was second in lane five. And third place in lane three was Lewis Cass. Culver Academy was fourth place.
Fourth in, yeah. So that means.
So Rochester cut their time by 5 seconds from
awesome.
The prelims.
That My guess, is that a school record, Mason?
I'm looking right now.
All right.
140.15 is what Rochester swam. The state cut time is 139. So even if they didn't get first place, that was one heck
coaches,
of a swim by
coaches,
all of the girls.
Last call to turn in your coaching ballot. Last call, coaches, for your coaching ballot.
That was a school record by 4 seconds.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Awesome. 4 seconds.
Is that our first official state qualifier this?
Yep.
Official.
Okay.
Official, yeah.
And say that last part again
results
with the records.
The girls 200-yard freestyle relay.
They broke
place.
Their
Manchester,
old record, which is 144.84.
What? They blew it away by
wow.
4 seconds?
Yep.
Oh, my
Rolling
goodness.
Four and a half.
Holy
four and a half.
Moly.
Pretty close, right?
Yeah.
It was great swims from all of them.
Like we said, the best time to do it is now. You're going to smash the record. Do it when it counts.
Gracie.
We just
Binsford.
Picked up. Between
Maya,
that event
Dominique
and the other event, 4 points on Culver.
Tenth great.
And
we were down by six going in.
We were down by.
Tammy
so that
Stewart.
Could push us up into second
right.
place.
Von
unofficially.
Macy Moon.
We were down by six,
ninth
so we're now
place.
Down by Frank two.
North. Emma Gordon. Alyssa Brinkman. Elena Shroop. Olivia Iding.
Great swim to the ladies. That was
eighth
awesome.
Place, Tippy Valley, Mady Fear, Blake McBriar.
I'll bet you'll see
Olivia
big smiles Ranger, when they're up on the.
I think so Brader, too.
Getting their ribbons.
Seventh place, Plymouth.
And
Leah
I imagine
Smith,
some of those parents
McKenzie
have gone down
Sheets,
there to take pictures.
I'm McKayla sure they're swarming Ebert, down there.
Jessica Drury. Sixth place, Wabash, Morgan Owens. Alexis
it's kind
Hartley,
of talented to get all four of them
Mallory
up there on the block.
Hipskin, Katie Ford, fifth place, Columbia
and they broke
City,
the school record.
Shauna Young, Lauren Liston,
next weekend.
Maggie Vandersall, Lindsay Hoskins, fourth place, Culver Academy. Aminia,
four and a half seconds.
Beach Horton. Janelle Lee, Sydney Brackenberry, Kylie Dinner, third place, Cass Paige Buechner, Maddie Carmel, Marisol Carmel, Hannah Young, second place, Warsaw, Olivia Herman, Laurel Moeller, Taylor Gunter, Brenna Morgan, and in first place, Rochester.
Woo!
With Abigail McCarter, Emma Feldman, Maria Hunting, Madeline Saylor.
Great job, girls.
Well, that means that last relay, the 400 free relay, is going to be a mighty interesting finish.
Yes, absolutely.
For Rochester.
Girls,
we'd rather it come down to the end, though, make it exciting.
Constellation.
Mm-hmm. So this is the
backstroke.
Event number 10. The consolation heat of the backstroke.
We only have two in this.
Lane one, Event Malagon, Warsaw. Lane two, Alyssa Brinkman, Huntington. Lane three, Sarah Schaller, Rochester. Lane four, Maddie Carmel, Cass. Lane five, Kelly Fry, Columbia City. Lane six, Elizabeth Ellert, Culver Academies. Lane seven, Elena Stroop, Huntington. Lane eight, Maddie Fear from Tippy Valley.
Sarah Schaller's catching up a little bit.
Good, because Culver Academy has three swimmers in this, and we only have two, one here and one in the finals.
Yep.
So that's going to make quite a difference. And Culver Academy has two in the finals.
Looks like it's going to be close between six and four.
Like four was second.
Lane six, that was Culver Academy's Ellert, was first place. Second place in lane four was Lewis Cass Carmel. And third place was lane five, Schaller from Rochester.
Well, Schaller was in three. Oh, okay, fourth.
The board's official. Championship of the girls 100-yard backstroke.
So we are preparing for the 100-yard finals. We'll be back after this.
RTC TV Channel 4 is Fulton County's only local television station. RTC advertising can insert 30-second commercials, sponsored programs, or business spotlights into Channel 4 and any of our top 12 most watched cable networks. If you don't have a commercial, RTC Advertising can create one for you. RTC Advertising wants your ad to succeed. With RTC Advertising, our audience is your audience. Your success is our success. RTC Advertising.
Give your heart to your community this Valentine's Day with a special dedication from the Fulton County Community Foundation and their media partners. Each year, your contributions help fund countless community needs, from parks and playgrounds to scholarships and grants. This Valentine's Day, give the gift that keeps on giving. Choose from a song dedication, singing Valentine's in person, or even a Palentine for your pet. Contact the Community Foundation or pick up your order form from one of these locations.
Lane 4, Delaney Weebring from Warsaw. Lane 5, Sophia Hatcher from Columbia City. Lane 6, Erica Mullins from Logansport. Lane 7, Kennedy Campbell from Rochester. Lane 8, Audrey Kirsten from Warsaw.
The final heat of the 100-yard backstroke.
Come on, Kennedy.
So Rochester's Kennedy Campbell in lane seven. And in the lead in lane four is Weibrink from Warsaw.
She's gonna have a nice time. They look pretty floored over there with the coaches.
And first place, Weibrink with 30. Oh, just kidding. Just under a minute. Second place was lane six. Erica Mullins from Logan Sport. And third place in lane five, that's Sophia Hatcher from Columbia City.
Hi, I'm Chris Smith, PGA Tour player and Rochester native. Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester congratulates all of our local sports teams on another great season. Your hard work and dedication has made us all proud. We wish all of our local teams the best of luck in the postseason tournaments. Drive home a victory for your community. We are behind you here at Shepherd's.
Scholar, Rochester. 11th place, Kelly Fry from Columbia City. 10th place, Maddie Carmel of Cass. 9th place, Elizabeth Ellert, Culver Academy. 8th place, Kennedy Campbell, Rochester. 7th place, Audrey Kirsten, Warsaw. 6th place, Gracie Holmes, Plymouth. 5th place, Kristen Graham of Culver Academy. 4th place, Avery Bolton, Culver Academy. 3rd place, Sophia Hatcher from Columbia City. 2nd place, Erica Mullins, Logansport. And from Warsaw, first place, Delaney Weebring.
Good job, Delaney.
Consolation of the girls' 100-yard breaststroke.
Consolation heat for the 100-yard breaststroke.
Lane one, Cora Barnett, Manchester.
You got him.
Lane two, Alexis Hartley, Wabash. Lane three, Ella Knight, Warsaw. Lane four, Megan Chan, Pioneer. Lane five, Cassie Hardy, Cass. Lane six, Gabby Line, Huntington. Lane seven, Abigail Newell from Logansport. Lane 8, Mackenzie Sheets from Plymouth.
Like this is going to be close.
It is.
That's first place in lane three, Ella Knight. Second place in lane four, Megan Chan. And third place, lane five, Cassie Hardy.
And this next heat, our
the board Abby, is official.
Our Abby
McCarter.
McCarter is seated first,
yep.
So we are hoping that
finals
she continues
of the
that.
Girls 100-yard breaststroke.
RTC Fiber Communications is now serving the community of Argus. Now you can enjoy the incredibly fast speed and reliability of fiber internet. Stream movies, surf the web, or watch your favorite local videos on RTC4.com. All from RTC Fiber Communications, now serving Argus. Give RTC a call today or check us out online at www.rtc1.com.
Are you in pain from an injury or arthritis? What if there was a place that could meet all of your orthopedic needs? A place with some of the best orthopedic doctors and staff in the Midwest. A place where you're treated as a person instead of a patient. What if that place weren't in Chicago or Indianapolis? There is such a place. Rochester Orthopedics, your regional orthopedic specialist. When you're looking for comfort and relief, remember, trust the board-certified and fellowship-trained surgeons at Rochester Orthopedics.
Madeline McGee from Culver Academy. Lane four, Abigail McCarter from Rochester. Lane five, Laurel Mower from Warsaw. Lane six, Megan Cummings from Columbia City. Lane seven, Allie Cardin from Cass. Lane eight, Macy Lane from Huntington.
This is the final heat of the 100-yard backstroke.
Breaststroke.
Breaststroke, sorry. There is a difference. And this is event number 11 of 12 for this sectional final.
Great pull out from
Great pull out. She's pulling up strong. There was her dolphin kick and the one pull, one kick she's allowed before she comes up. She's way out in front of everybody. Now she's seated way in front of everybody, but you never know when you get that final with that taper.
The split time is about 31, it looks like.
31?
Yeah.
That's great.
Yeah.
Great time. There it is, 31:39. It's up on the bottom of our screen now. She ought to break a 110 for sure.
Oh, yeah.
That was 110.36 is what she swam in the prelims.
And she's way a,
There you go, Abby.
Come on, Ab. She's going to be about 106. 105.
Wow.
Wow.
105, maybe. Nice swim, Abby.
That is
great
impressive.
Swim. She's going to be jumping for joy when she sees that final time come up.
106.54.
I was close when I said 106.
So in first place in lane four was Abby McCarter. Second place in lane five, Laurel Moralmore. And third place, lane three, Madeline McGee.
Was lane two eighth place, am I correct? Because that was a Culver swimmer.
So yes, eighth place was lane two.
That's a Culver.
So Abby McCarter shaving off 4 seconds.
That's phenomenal.
From her prelim time, congratulations.
What was the state cut in that?
State cut was 105.94.
Results of the girls' 100-yard breaststroke. 16th place, Mackenzie Sheets of Plymouth. 15th place, Abigail Newell from Logansport. 14th place, Cora Barnett from Manchester. 13th place, Alexis Hartley from Wabash. 12th place, Gabby Line from Huntington North. 11th place, Cassie Hardy from Cass. 10th place, Megan Chan from Pioneer. 9th place, Ella Knight from Warsaw. 8th place, Janelle Lee from Culver Academies. 7th place, Macy Lane from Huntington North. 6th place, Allie Carden from Cass. 5th place, Madeline Ray from Warsaw. 4th place, Megan.
Job.
So that is our Rochester's second for sure state qualifier.
Correct.
First was the relay team, and now Abby McCarter on her own with the 100-yard breaststroke.
And now she's got to turn right around and swim that 400 free relay. And
it was hopefully the excitement from winning will give her a little bit of adrenaline in this relay.
Right.
Usually it seems to work that way.
It does.
When you do well, then it carries over. So this is the 400-yard freestyle relay consolation heat. Manchester in lane 3, Logan Sport in lane 4, Tippecanoe Valley in lane 5, and Wabash in lane 6. So
lane
the very last event.
Sky. Free coat. Haley Wampler. Tawny Fuentes. Cora Barnett. Lane 4 from Logansport, Erica Mullins, Abigail Newell, Isabel Proud, Sophia Rosie. Lane 5 from Tippy, Blake McBriar, Olivia Livingood, Mady Fear, Kinsey Prater. Lane 6 from Wabash, Gracie Shoning, Lakin McCord, Olivia Hipskin, Caitlin Tracy.
Deliver!
It'll be interesting to see if they give her a little more time to rest and put Maddie first in her last.
So it looks like Logan Sport is in the lead for the consolation heat of the 400-yard freestyle relay. This is the last, second to last swimmer?
I think.
Third. This is third swimmer?
I think that is the last swimmer.
That's the last one?
I think, yes.
And that's Logan Sport in lane four. So Logan Sport wins the consolation heat of the 400-yard freestyle relay.
Tip was second.
What?
Tippecanoe Valley was second.
Tippecanoe Valley was second place. And third place in lane three was Manchester. So we are coming into the final heat of the final event of girls sectionals. 400-yard freestyle relay. We'll be back right after this.
RTC TV Channel 4 is Fulton County's only local television station. RTC advertising can insert 30-second commercials, sponsored programs, or business spotlights into Channel 4 and any of our top 12 most watched cable networks. If you don't have a commercial, RTC Advertising can create one for you. RTC Advertising wants your ad to succeed. With RTC Advertising, our audience is your audience. Your success is our success. RTC Advertising.
Give your heart to your community this Valentine's Day with a special dedication from the Fulton County Community Foundation and their media partners. Each year, your contributions help fund countless community needs, from parks and playgrounds to scholarships and grants. This Valentine's Day, give the gift that keeps on giving. Choose from a song dedication, singing Valentine's in person, or even a Palentine for your pet. Contact the Community Foundation or pick up your order form from one of these locations.
Hi, I'm Chris Smith, PGA Tour player and Rochester native. Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester congratulates all of our local sports teams on another great season. Your hard work and dedication has made us all proud. We wish all of our local teams the best of luck in the postseason tournaments. Drive home a victory for your community. We are behind you here at Shepherd's.
RTC Fiber Communications is now serving the community of Argus. Now you can enjoy the incredibly fast speed and reliability of fiber internet. Stream movies, surf the web, or watch your favorite local videos on RTC4.com. All from RTC Fiber Communications, now serving Argus. Give RTC a call today or check us out online at www.rtc1.com.
Are you in pain from an injury or arthritis? What if there was a place that could meet all of your orthopedic needs? A place with some of the best orthopedic doctors and staff in the Midwest. A place where you're treated as a person instead of a patient. What if that place weren't in Chicago or Indianapolis? There is such a place. Rochester Orthopedics, your regional orthopedic specialist. When you're looking for comfort and relief, remember, trust the board-certified and fellowship-trained surgeons at Rochester Orthopedics.
Huntington, Emma Helmich, Allie Oshorman, Lainey Shaw, Macy Lane, Lane 4 from Rochester, Emma Feldman, Maria Huntington, Abigail McCarter, Madeline Saylor, Lane 5 from Cass, Paige Buechner, Maddie Carmel, Marisol Carmel, Hannah Young, lane 6 from Culver Academy, Kylie Dinner, Janelle Lee, Avery Bolden, Ella Spratt-Sarzinski. Lane 7 from Columbia City, Maggie Vandersall, Kelly Fry, Lauren Liston, Sophia Hatcher. Lane 8 from Plymouth, Leah Smith, Nicole Horvath, Devin Britton, Gracie Hall.
Championship of the 400-yard freestyle relay and also the final event of the sectional finals at Warsaw. And Rochester is in lane 4. Emma Feldman, our first swimmer, first leg of the relay.
And we have our two best swimmers swimming third and fourth as far as the 100 free. Emma's right up in there.
Yep.
But with giving Abby McCarter a little bit of a rest after that breaststroke, they put her third with Maddie as fourth.
Put her in the third position.
Mm-hmm. Emma's had quite a night.
Yes.
With herself, but with her events today as well. Shaving off quite a bit of time. You got to watch lane 6.
Yeah.
Warsaw, isn't it?
Warsaw.
Oh, no, it's CMA.
Yes.
Warsaw
is in lane
2. You got to watch them as well.
This is going to be a close race.
Yes.
For sure.
Well, Maria pulled out there, but I'm looking at Warsaw.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think you'll see the difference. I mean,
oh,
I think Maria will pull it out some here, but then...
Over in lane 6, too, you can
right.
see CMA.
Mm-hmm.
This is not going to be easily decided. It'll probably be up to the scoreboard to see who was...
And it'll be, you know, that third and fourth swimmer have yet to go.
Right.
Right.
And... come on, Maria.
Hold on, Maria.
Like CMA's pulling ahead. Warsaw
is in second.
Coming in.
Still a very close race. Great start from Abby.
Abby McCarter in the water for Rochester right now in lane 4.
She's gone past 3. And just coming up on lane 6 from Warsaw. Come on, Ab. I think she's real close to lane 2 as well. 2
yep.
is Warsaw. 6 is Culver Academy.
Yep.
Now Warsaw has that other really good swimmer.
Yes, Weibrink is the last leg for Warsaw.
There you go, Abby.
Abby's pulled ahead of the Culver Academy girl.
There we go. Good turn.
There, nice good. Turn. Great turn by Abby. Great turn.
She gets a
there
good
go,
lead
Abby.
For Maddie
Come on,
Sailor,
Abby.
The last swimmer here.
And Abby should be able to bring that in.
And Maddie's in the water.
Come on, Maddie.
And Warsaw
is right on him.
Right on her tail.
Come on, Maddie. Ooh.
Oh, great turn.
And Whitebrink right there as well.
Yep.
One more 50.
I was looking to see in lane 1 ahead of her, and she's almost lapping her.
Yes, that's what I was.
I was like, whoa, whoa, whoa.
Skipped my heart, too.
Yes.
I thought, holy moly, we missed them. But yes.
yes.
So
Come
Maddie
on, all
is
the way in,
the
Maddie.
Lead.
Let's go, Maddie. Keep going now.
Last half of the pool here.
Yes.
Yes.
And that will be the third qualifying swim for the Rochester Lady Zebras here. First place in lane 4 was Rochester. Maddie Sailors with a strong finish. Second place was lane 2, Warsaw. And third place was Lane 6 with Culver Academy. So we knew we knew it was close coming into that.
Get that out and see if that's a new record.
And
I'll
344.
That's a major drop.
Oh, my goodness. They swam a 357 on Thursday and a 344.
And they just broke the record by over four, by four or three, a little over three.
They broke the record by
again,
four,
yeah.
four, about three and a half.
So is this the second record the relay teams have broken today?
Yep.
Congratulations. So the
Great
Rochester
job.
Lady Zebras will be going to state in the 200-yard relay.
200 free relay.
And the 400 freestyle relay. And then Abby McCarter will be going for the
breaststroke.
200 breaststroke?
100 breaststroke.
100 breaststroke. So our three state qualifying races here, and then possibly more to come with state cut times as the day goes on. Is that
possibly,
right?
Possibly, yeah.
Possibly.
So great swim overall for all teams. A great sectional final here. I don't know about you guys, but I've learned a lot and saw a lot of good competition between this and the diving. So thank you for joining us. Abby Malko here with Mason Brady and Carmen Reeves. This is Scott Sager and also Tim Wagner here with RTC TV4. We're going to run some ads. Thanks for watching at Warsaw High School Girls Sectional Finals.
Great job.
RTC TV Channel 4 is Fulton County's only local television station. RTC advertising can insert 30-second commercials, sponsored programs, or business spotlights into Channel 4 and any of our top 12 most watched cable networks. If you don't have a commercial, RTC advertising can create one for you. RTC advertising wants your ad to succeed. With RTC advertising, our audience is your audience. Your success is our success. RTC advertising.
Give your heart to your community this Valentine's Day with a special dedication from the Fulton County Community Foundation and their media partners. Each year, your contributions help fund countless community needs, from parks and playgrounds to scholarships and grants. This Valentine's Day, give the gift that keeps on giving. Choose from a song dedication, singing Valentine's in person, or even a Palentine for your pet. Contact the Community Foundation or pick up your order form from one of these locations.
Hi, I'm Chris Smith, PGA Tour player and Rochester native. Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester congratulates all of our local sports teams on another great season. Your hard work and dedication has made us all proud. We wish all of our local teams the best of luck in the postseason tournaments. Drive home a victory for your community. We are behind you here at Shepherd's.
RTC Fiber Communications is now serving the community of Argus. Now you can enjoy the incredibly fast speed and reliability of fiber internet. Stream movies, surf the web, or watch your favorite local videos on RTC4.com. All from RTC Fiber Communications, now serving Argus. Give RTC a call today or check us out online at www.rtc1.com.
Ella Trapp Sarzinski, second place from Warsaw, Olivia Herman, Lauren Kuhl, Taylor Gunter, Delaney Weebrink, and first place from Rochester, Emma Feldman, Bria Hunting, Abigail McCarter, and Madeline
RTC TV Channel 4 is Fulton County's only local television station. RTC advertising can insert 30-second commercials, sponsored programs, or business spotlights into Channel 4 and any of our top 12 most watched cable networks. If you don't have a commercial, RTC advertising can create one for you. RTC advertising wants your ad to succeed. With RTC advertising, our audience is your audience. Your success is our success. RTC advertising.